Hello, I'm Cindy Matsen. I'm a breast cancer surgeon at Huntsman Cancer Institute at the University of Utah. In this video, I'm going to be describing what information we use to help us make decisions about your breast cancer treatment. The amount of information you receive can be overwhelming, so please write down any questions you might have to ask the members of your healthcare team. And please don't worry if you need to ask to have information repeated. We are happy to go over everything until you understand. We confirm that you have breast cancer when the pathologist looked under the microscope at the sample of tissue, called a biopsy, that was removed from your breast. That close-up look gave us lots of important information about your cancer. When the pathologist looked at your biopsy under the microscope, the first thing they look at is what type of cancer cells are present. This is a side view of the breast and a pop-out of breast tissue. These grape-like structures at the ends are called lobules, and that is where breast milk is made. These tubes are called ducts, and they carry the breast milk from the lobules out through the nipple. Two types of breast cancer are the most common. Invasive ductal carcinoma makes up about 80% of breast cancers, and invasive lobular carcinoma makes up about 10%. There are also mixed types and other special rare types, and we'll go over exactly what type of cancer you have when we meet in clinic. Just so you know, infiltrating and invasive mean the same thing, and you may see either term on your pathology report. The next thing pathologists look at under the microscope is the grade of your cancer, and grade is not the same as stage. Grade means how abnormal do the cancer cells look and how quickly are they growing and dividing. Knowing this gives us an idea of how aggressive this cancer might be and what treatments may be useful. Grade is scored from 1 to 3, with 1 being the least abnormal and 3 being the most abnormal. Another important piece of information from the pathology report is the receptors on the cancer. Receptors are like little antennae on the surface of the cell that pick up signals and tell the cell what to do. In breast cancer, there are 3 receptors that are important because they help us understand what treatments you might need. These receptors are the estrogen receptor, the progesterone receptor, and the HER2 receptor, which is a growth factor receptor. When you come to see your surgeon, the two of you will go over your pathology report together and we'll discuss what treatments will be recommended based on the receptors on your cancer. Other important information comes from your imaging, such as mammogram, ultrasound, and MRI, and the physical exam that I'll perform when I see you in clinic. This information is called clinical information, and it helps us understand what stage your cancer is. Stage is a term we use to describe how much a cancer has spread and understand what treatments may be needed. The staging for breast cancer is a TNM system, and I will explain what each of those letters mean. The T in the staging system stands for tumor size and goes from small, T1, to large, T4. We know how big the tumor is from your imaging and my exam. The N in the staging system stands for lymph nodes. We care about lymph nodes because when breast cancer spreads, it usually goes to the lymph nodes first. And most of the time, these are the lymph nodes under your arm. When your surgeon examines you, he or she will feel under your arms for any abnormal lymph nodes. You will also get an ultrasound under your arm to look for abnormal nodes. Any abnormal nodes that show on the ultrasound will be biopsied, even if they can't be felt. The last part of staging is M, which stands for metastasis. A metastasis is cancer that is spread from the breast to other parts of your body. If you have an early stage cancer, the likelihood this has happened is very, very low, so we don't do any special tests to check. If you have a later stage cancer, your surgeon may recommend a special scan to check for cancer in other parts of your body. All of this information tells us what kind of cancer you have, how it might behave, and a first assessment of its clinical stage. Your surgeon will tell you what clinical stage your cancer is when you visit in the clinic. Remember, clinical stage is based on information that we have before surgery. Surgery will give us more precise information, and the final pathology report will give us your pathologic stage, which other treatments may be based on. So we do surgery for 2 reasons: to remove the disease and to get more information. In the next video, I will discuss the surgical treatment of breast cancer. Thank you and take care.